Can the Supreme Court order a stop on the canvassing of votes and proclamation of presumptive President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. set next week? This is the ultimate question the High Court has to resolve after two groups of petitioners asked for the issuance of a temporary restraining order. For civic leaders and martial law survivors, it's important for the Supreme Court to resolve first if Mr. Marcos is qualified to run for public office before he can be proclaimed president. But the Marcos camp is opposing the petitions. In a manifestation submitted to the Supreme Court Thursday, Marcos's lawyer, former Solicitor General Estelito Mendoza, argued the Supreme Court has no jurisdiction to issue a TRO to stop the canvassing and proclamation.
That is not allowed by the Constitution because the Constitution very prudently provide for explicit dates when the canvassing shall take place. It provides explicitly within what time the Senate President shall open the certificates of canvass received from every province and chartered city.
Under the Constitution, the Senate President is mandated to open the certificates of canvass in the presence of both the Senate and the House of Representatives within 30 days from the date of the election. After which, the person having the highest number of votes shall be proclaimed elected. The same provision under the Constitution also provides for the exact date and time when a president's term ends and the next president's term begins, at 12 noon on the 30th day of June, following the day of the election held every 6 years. Marcos said the Senate and the House of Representatives, sitting as the National Board of Canvassers, are obliged to follow what he called mandatory periods in the Constitution. But former UP College of Law Dean Pacifico Agabin disagrees, saying it is within the powers of the Supreme Court to issue a TRO.
It is the Supreme Court and bank, which is the sole judge of all elections, returns, and qualifications of candidates for the presidency and the vice presidency. The expanded power of the Supreme Court gives them the power to determine whether there has been a grave abuse of discretion amounting to lack of jurisdiction.
For Attorney Rico Domingo, immediate past president of the Philippine Bar Association, this issue needs to be resolved by the Supreme Court soon.
Yun ang dapat ihulog sa ano sa katastasan suprema, no, ang ating katastasan korte. Dapat mabigyan tayo ng guidance ano dapat gawin. This is a golden opportunity for the Supreme Court under the leadership of Chief Justice Esmundo to show us how are we going to chart our future advocacies as legal practitioners.
On Thursday, the Supreme Court ordered Marcos, the COMELEC, the Senate, and the House of Representatives to file their comments on the petitions against Marcos's candidacy. But it did not issue a TRO. Instead, it gave respondents 15 days to comment, which is beyond the date of the expected proclamation next week. For Mendoza, this is a win for his client.
Victory, not only for my client, but for the Filipino people to know that they will have a new president as mandated by their votes cast in the last election by an overwhelming majority. You must not overlook the majority which BBM obtained in the last elections.
Agabin and Domingo agree it will be difficult for the Supreme Court to ignore the 31 million votes Marcos obtained in the recent polls.
Mahirap yatang salungatin yun. Pero again, the petition as filed would raise very quintessential issues, no? Very important issues na dapat talagang bigyan konsiderasyon ng court.
At this point, only a TRO from the Supreme Court can stop Marcos's looming proclamation. Marcos's camp intends to move for the dismissal of the pending petitions before the Supreme Court once he is proclaimed president.
A comment is required to be filed on the petition, and therefore, in the comment, you may expect that we will be asking for the dismissal of the petition, the Senate and the Congress, or the same Congress, have no jurisdiction to determine the question raised in the petition.
But if the Supreme Court were to rule against Marcos, COMELEC Commissioner George Garcia explains, the outcome will depend on which kind of petition would prevail, either the cancellation of Marcos's certificate of candidacy or the disqualification case against him.
Pag cancellation of candidacy, tanggal siya, at ang uupo ay yung second placer. Whoever will get the highest number of votes after sa kanya. Okay po, yun yung tinatawag na cancellation of candidacy. Bakit? Kasi ang sabi ng Supreme Court, Fermin versus COMELEC, Tagolino versus the Commission of Election, dahil hindi siya naging kandidato, so to speak. Now, kung ang kaso ay disqualification, pero nanalo pa rin siya after the election, tsaka siya na-disqualify. Question, sinong uupo? Ang uupo ay hindi po yung hindi second po yung speaker, ang uupo by succession. Bakit? Kasi kandidato naman siya. Kaya lang, meron siyang na-violate.
Petitioners, however, argue that under a 2013 Supreme Court ruling, even a second placer can take over a disqualified candidate if the ground for disqualification existed at the time of the filing of the COC. And this can happen even after a disqualified candidate has been proclaimed and has assumed office. Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.